MV, attack percent, physical percent. These guys had many names by many sources over the years. Some of you voted, and today, I'll oblige. Let's talk motion values.
DPS, this, crit meta, that, motion value.
No matter how long you've played Monster Hunter, how experienced or good you are, you know that weapons have different attacks that mostly have different animations, timings, and feel. While still true in older entries, ever since World, we can openly see that not all attacks are created equal, and that the damage differs, sometimes wildly. One reason behind that are motion values, or MV. Generally speaking, MV translate any given attack into computable numbers. Let's look at an example. Switch Axis Axe Mode's Overhead Slash. Try saying that one fast. Has a motion value of 45, which means that 45% of your attack, or raw, is used in damage calculation. In modern games, motion values are completely detached from player choice, meaning you cannot impact them with armor skills or playstyle choice. They are hard-coded values. Unless you're bowguns, then stuff's a little bit different, but I don't feel qualified to talk about that, frankly. Both element and status have a similar mechanic, except they are called element and status mod, respectively. Unlike MB, Ellie and status mod are expressed as decimal numbers, which, for all intent and purposes, still behave like percentages. Switch Axis Axe Mode's Overhead Slash has an element of 1, meaning 100% of your element is applied in damage calculation. Switch Axis File Ticks have an element of 0.35, meaning 35% of your element is applied in damage calculation. Generally speaking, if you want to figure out what the MV of any particular attack is, you have two options if a game is newly released, and a third if it is not. Option 1 is keeping an eye out on data mines. Even though they can sometimes be a little bit off, after a couple days of them coming out, there has usually been a collective effort of knowledgeable people mapping them out and correcting them. Option 2 is what these people do. Hit something, and then, depending on game, either apply the damage number on screen in damage calculation and reverse the formula to solve for MV, or throw rocks at an Aptonoth. Option 3 becomes available usually a couple of weeks to months into the game's lifecycle, depending on how enjoyable the theory people think that particular release is. Most good guides will link a resource containing a list of MV that has been vetted and verified. Checking one of the many calculators that spawn around that data can also lead you to the right information. Eventually, these things become vague community knowledge, meaning anyone around for a while will sort of passively pick up on either the exact numbers or where to find them. Note that community here doesn't mean obscure forums or the big, more casual subreddits, but dedicated groups and places where people either want to learn or teach or generally improve at the games, either in knowledge or skill. On top of helping determine raw damage output, MV is also used for some skill conditions such as Bloodlust or Frenzy, where a certain total amount of MV has to connect with a monster in order to fulfill those conditions. As an example, in order to overcome the first Frenzy activation of Bloodlust 1 in Sunbreak, you'll need to land a total of 600 MV. And that's that. That's all you need to know about motion values.
Why is there so much video left?
Remember when I said...
From there, it's just a matter of rounding, adding, and multiplying numbers according to the damage formula, which is its own can of worms that I'm not willing to open for the sake of this info piece.
Fine.
How about you motion value for some bitches?
Simplified, this is the damage formula. Let's break it down. On the raw side, we know what motion value is and can fill that out. For overhead slash, that's 45. Base raw here refers to the attack value of your weapon. The only things that affect base raw are augments and augment-like systems. Think the tiered weapon upgrades in Portable 3rd, augments and custom upgrades in World and Iceborne, and Curious Crafting for weapons in Sunbreak. Let's take the Zoshiya Switch Axe as an example. It has 220 base raw and no further base raw modifications. Raw percent refers to skills that grant a percentage boost to raw. These are things like modern attack boost or heroics. Having multiple sources of raw percent makes him stack multiplicatively. Plus 10% from attack boost and 30% from heroics translates to plus 43% instead of 40%. This set uses Guts, which grants plus 5% attack while the secondary effect is unused. The base value for this slot in calculation is 1 or 100%. So we can fill it out as 105% or 1.05. To that result, we add flat raw. Flat raw describes anything that gives a flat, predetermined amount of attack. This category entails skills such as Burst, the flat portion of attack boost, but also items such as Might Seed and Pill and Demon Powder and Drugs. While this set has Burst 1, it will not be active during this attack. Counter-Strike 3 adds 25 raw, and Agitator 5 adds 20. Flat raw stacks additively for a total of plus 45 attack. The next step is post-raw modifiers. These have been almost entirely removed from Wilds. To my knowledge, at the time of writing, only Dual Blades have one of these with their Demon Mode shenanigans. In the past, skills like Frostcraft or Grinder S would fall into this category, as well as things like Switch Axe's Power File. Post modifiers, like Raw Percent, stack multiplicatively. Files are now base, and we attack an axe, so our post modifier is 1. That completes the raw stat calculation. What remains is multiplication. For the purpose of damage calculation, the exact intricacies of when and where these factors apply is not important, as multiplication has commutative properties, meaning the result doesn't change if you swap the order. Sharpness has different levels to it, all of which have different values attached to them. For white sharpness, the raw modifier is 1.32, which we can put into the formula. Next is crit. Critical hits, by default, deal 25% more raw damage. Critical boost ups that percentage, depending on game. In World on Rise, crit boost added plus 5 per level, so 30, 35, and 40% extra raw damage respectively. Just to be abundantly clear, critical boost changes the modifier from 25% to 40% at crit boost 3 in those games specifically. In Wilds, crit boost adds plus 3 instead, but works the same otherwise. Since we use crit boost 3, our critical modifier is 1.34. We can put that in. The last step is hit zone. Similar to MV, they are percent values. Hit zone of 50 means 50% of the calculated total raw stat is applied. A hit zone of 25 means 25% is applied, and so on. The value of the hit zone we are attacking here is 80, or 80%, or value of 0.8, resulting in 175.7 raw damage. Next is element, which works largely in the same way. Our base element is 15 Dragon. While in the status screen it says 150, element and status are, for some reason, bloated with no option to change that. This means they get inflated to display as a larger number than was actually used in calculation. Element and status bloat is 10, so we divide whatever number is there by 10 to get a true value. 150 divided by 10 is 15. We don't have base or percent modifiers, so it remains 15. Similar to raw, base element is only influenced by augments or augment-like systems and never by armor skills. Ally percent also stack multiplicatively, the same way raw percent does. Examples of ally percent include skills such as the individual element attacks or coalescence. Next is flat ally. This encapsulates skills such as burst or the flat portion of the individual ally attacks. While we do have burst 1, it is not active for this attack, so we have plus 0 flat element for a total of 15. Post ally behaves the exact same way as post raw does. Things like element exploit or frostcraft fall under this category. Much like raw, swax files used to go here, but in wilds they don't. Since we don't have any of these on this set, the value for this is 1, putting us at a grand total of 15 dragon element. Next up is sharpness, which for element is a 1.15 multiplier, that we can put into the formula. Critical element is the first major difference to raw calculation. Unlike raw damage, element cannot crit right out of the gate. Instead, you need to use the critical element skill, which grants every attack that crits the respective bonus modifier. In some games, like Wilds, this modifier differs between weapons, in others like Rise, it doesn't. Since we don't use critical element on this set at all, that value is 1. We can put that in. Alimod works like MB does, but for element. Why it's called Alimod is beyond me, but that's what it's called. Unlike MB, however, it is typically not listed as a percentage, but as a decimal number that is directly used in calculation. Most moves have an element of 1, meaning that 100% of the calculated element is used in calculation. Overhead slash is one of those moves. We can put in 1 for the modifier into the formula. File ticks and full release ticks have, at the time of writing, an element of 0.35, which translates to 35% of the calculated element being applied. Just to give an example of a non-1 move and its behavior. The final bit is elemental hitzone. These work exactly like raw hitzones. The dummy's attacked elemental hitzone value, or e-hitzone for short, is 30, meaning that the multiplier is 30% or 0.3. We round the result to 1 decimal for 5.2 elemental damage. The last step is to add together the raw and elemental damages for a total damage of... And that is how damage calculation works. For standard attacks. On melee weapons. Some of them. Alright, there's caveats. Ranged weapons work a little bit differently. The formula is vaguely correct for all applications, but some moves just have to be a little bit special. An example of those are shields, that sometimes scale with sharpness and other times don't. Some attacks, like shells, have a fixed portion of fire damage attached to them that can skew things one way or another a little bit. There's cases like Chargeblade Elemental SAED that don't behave completely like standard MB and Alimod. Bowguns don't have an element stat, so their elemental ammo works a little bit different too, scaling off of their raw instead and having different interactions with skills that grant flat element. In some very rare cases, this formula breaks. Switchaxe in particular uses a slightly different formula in sword mode at the time of writing and recording. Specifically, the rounding is off compared to standard damage calculation. This is extremely noticeable with elemental damage, which, throwback, is why I memed in the FAQ around release that element is currently broken. The astute viewer will have noticed that the set used in this video has 100% affinity, which guarantees critical hits. What we have done here today is what I refer to as a snapshot calculation. We calculated one attack under one specific set of circumstances against one target, like a snapshot in time, hence snapshot calculation. There are two alternatives to snapshot. Number one is the average calculation, which is what most current guides use. It accounts for average uptimes on conditional skills. An easy example of this is latent power. It'd be silly to pretend that it just flat out gives 50% affinity at all times and permanently. A more reasonable approach to it on that scale is measuring and then extrapolating a standard uptime for it. Let's assume that latent power is up for exactly half of your hunt. That means that latent power, on average, provides 25% affinity. This approach extends to every skill when doing uptime or average calculations. The second approach is simulation. What that entails is a mix of the two approaches, calculating whole phases of how skills align, how big their impact is at any given point, and how that translates into full hunts and general performance of a given set. This type of calculation is almost completely unused currently, as it is a lot of effort to set up and then go through. Considering that most calculators are built for casual players, and speedrun performance, where such a calculation would be the most interesting, underlies very different rules compared to normal gameplay, the overall benefit of pursuing it is nearly non-existent compared to improving upon the previous tools and guides. So to recap, there's 3 options for calculation. Snapshot calculations that only ever care if a skill is currently on or off, which is very good for getting fast results and a general overview of a set's min and max performance, but not very accurate when calculating for others. Average calculation, which accounts for uptimes and conditionals, which is good at getting reasonably accurate average results, especially when building for the purpose of a guide, but with the downside of having to assume uptimes. And simulations, which are extremely accurate and useful, but also extremely time-intensive to set up and alter. You now know how damage calculation works. Hooray! In the description, you can find a link to a written version of this video that goes into depth a little bit more. Feel free to leave any further questions in the comments, and special thanks to DigChess for writing the guide with me.